I was there the day it happened. Traveling the world is what I did for a living. What great views I saw, exotic places I got to explore. I was always up for an adventure. Everything was wonderful and life was going so well. It was a new day and I was craving to have such an adventurous day. Birds were singing, the sun was smiling, and everything seemed just right. I looked up at the great London buildings and beautiful sky and said, "London, I'm a very strange and adventurous human. Watch out." Later, as I was out exploring such new things and places, I had found out there had been a massive earthquake in the United States. My family and I live in the United States, and it was not just in one city or state. It was the whole country. Immediately, I ran to the nearest phone booth and dialed the number of my family while my hands and fingers shaking as if I were the one experiencing such horror. There was no answer, and I was just standing there, frozen with such horror in my eyes. "I do not know what to do," I whispered. No one picked up on the other end. There has been a massive earthquake along the United States, and I had no contact with my family. Most importantly, I had no contact with the love of my life. I traveled alone, and not knowing anything about my family or my love was terrifying. I did not know what to do. Instantly, I reached for my phone as I hear it ring. "We're safe, we're together, everything is fine," my mother exclaimed with such pain. "You are right, everything will be okay," I said. Little do we know the earthquake was coming again, but not just to the United States, but everywhere. The earthquake was going to be even worse, dangerous, and powerful than the one that hit the United States. This one hurt everything, everyone. Everything I ever did wrong, everything hit me. All the things I did that were bad choices all came to me like a wave passing by in the ocean. Every time I let my parents down by lying to them, letting my friends down, I was thousands of miles away from everyone I had wished to be with, everyone I had ever let down who still loved me even after all my mistakes, and I could not even be with them for the end. I called a person I had not heard from but wanted to so badly. "Are you okay? I wish I could be with you," he whispers through the phone with a sigh. I did not want to hang up. He is the love of my life. I did not want to leave him. I did not want to leave Earth. My life was great. What had I done to deserve this? And then the sense came rushing back. All I wanted to remember was the people I love and what they had all done for me. They are the reason I am who I am. Slowly I knew it was the end. The end was coming. And I was alone. All I wanted to do was cry and panic and be with the love of my life. But I could not, and I was not going to. Slowly yet quickly, it was the end. And all I thought about was you, and how loving you felt. You can do it, won't you dance with me?